स्वयं ही सुत संपन्न शीलवृत्त गुणालय धितव्रत मृदुदात सत्वान मंत्रीक्षुषी गुद्भग्नि अतिथि विद्याना शुश्रुषु रणहंकृत सर्वभूत सुहित साधु मितवाग अनसूयक दीज आर क्वालिफिकेशन ऑफ द मस्ट एक्सॉल्टेड पर्सन इन द सोसाइटी द ब्राह्मण इज द टॉप मोस्ट division of human society, not by caste or by birth, but by qualification. These things are spoken about Ajami. These are Ajami Upakhyan, the history of Ajami. Ajamin, although he was a very well-trained Brahmana boy at the beginning of his life, but later on account of bad association, he became the most sinful man in the world. But at the end of his life, he chanted the holy name of Narayan, not meaning Narayana, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but his youngest son's name was Narayan. He called the holy name of Narayan, calling his son. He did not know that he is chanting the holy name of Narayana. And still he got salvation. That is the part of this history, that the holy name of God, Narayana, Krishna, Rama, there are many names of the Lord. Nam Namakari Bahudha. He has got thousands of names, and you can chant any one of them, either Krishna, Rama, Govinda, Narayana, like that. So you get the result. So here the example is the Ajamil, although he had forgotten Narayana, but on account of his chanting the holy name of Narayana, although he meant his son, it was effective. We have to understand like that. Somehow or other, if you chant the holy name of the Lord, knowingly or unknowingly, it will have its effect. Just like you touch fire, knowingly or unknowingly, it will burn. Similarly, if you chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra, knowingly or unknowingly, it will be effective on your life. Therefore, we see it practically that in the Western countries, although they did not know who is Narayan or Krishna, it is in the dictionary, English dictionary, there is statement Krishna is the name of Hindu god. So, but nobody is consulting dictionary for chanting Hare Krishna. But the Shastra says that somehow or other, if you chant the holy name of God, then you gradually become purified. Cheta darpanam arjanam, bhava mahadabhagni nidbapanam, shreya kairava chandrika vidaranam, vidyavadhu jivanam. So this history of Ajamil's life is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam to show the importance of chanting the holy name of God. That is the purpose. So the Ajamil later on becomes a great sinful person, therefore he has to be taken to Jamaraj. But because he chanted at the end of his life Narayana, he became purified from all sinful activities. So the order carriers of Narayana came to deliver him, save him from the hands of the Jamadut. So the Jamaduta is describing the history of Ajamil in the past, how he was in the beginning. Because he was a son of a Brahmin, his father trained up the Brahmin boy like a Brahmin. So, as such, he got this training. What is that? Ayam hi suta sampanyo. This boy got training to become expert in Vedic knowledge. Suta sampanyo. Suta means Vedic knowledge. And sampanna means finished. Within 12 years, a Brahmin's son is supposed to finish all the studies of Vedas, Vyakaran, grammar. That was education. From 5 years, he is trained up. He goes to, nowadays also the children are sent to school at 5 years age. But the mode of education depends. Formally, within 20 years, a student, a brahmachari, was trained up with all these qualifications, as it is described. What is that? The first is suta sampanna, expertly aware of Vedic knowledge. Ayam hi suta sampanya. Shila. Shila vritya gunalaya. Shila means suddhachar, cleansing. Because Brahman's qualification is samadama sattam. What is that? Samadama. Tapa-satyam, cleanliness. So, this is also trained up, how to become clean. To rise early in the morning, take bath, wash mouth with guna-sampanna, then take to Mangala-aritri. In this way, you are also trained up. Ayam hi suta sampanna sila vritta gunalaya. Guna means sadguna. This sama dama titiksha arjava gyanam vijnanam astikam. These are gunalaya, reservoir of all good qualities. Dhita vrata. These things not occasionally but regularly. Dhita vrata. I must rise early in the morning. That is called dhita-vrata, bhav. I must do it. Dhitavrata, mridu, mild, gentleness. This is human life. Not to live like cats and dogs. That is not human life. Real human life, the picture is here. One must be trained up to all these qualifications. Just like nowadays we send our boys to school, college, for being trained up as a technician. Formerly the boys were sent for education. These are the apex of education. Education means to become human being. Chanakya Pandit, he also, although he was a politician, but Brahmana, he also says, who is educated? Pandit. The Brahman is known as Pandit. So what is the sign of Pandit? He has summarized. Matrivat paradareshu paradrabheshu loshtavat atavat sarvabhuteshu japasyate sa pandit. Pandit means matrivat paradareshu. To accept all women as mother. Paradareshu. Dharu means wife and paro means other. Except his own wife, he should treat all women outside, taking them as mother. Therefore, still in Hindu society, every woman is addressed by an unknown man, mother. It doesn't matter if a person is unknown, he can speak with another woman, addressing her first, mother, Mataji, then nobody will be offended. This is the etiquette that is taught by Chanakya Pandit. Matrivat paradareshu. Woman should be addressed as mother. And paradarbheshu loshtava. And others' property should be accepted as some pebbles on the street. Nobody cares for it. If some pebbles, some stones are thrown in the street, nobody cares for it. Garbage. So nobody should touch others' property. Nowadays the education is how to make friendship with other wife and how to take away others' money by tricks. This is not education. The education is here. Matrivat paradareshu paradabheshu loshtavat atavat sarvabhuteshu. Sarvabhuteshu, in all living entities, there are 8,400,000 different forms of living entities. The grass is also a living entity, and Brahma is also a living entity. So, a Pandit accepts everyone as living entity, and he deals with them atvavat. What I feel, pains and pleasure, I must deal with others by the same sentiment. Therefore, modern days nationality means human being. But actually, the animals, they are also national. National means one is born in the same country, according to their definition. The national word is never found in the Vedic literature. This is modern invention. So, here atva sarvabhutesu. It doesn't matter whether one is national or outside or national. Sarvabhutesu. Here is also, it is said, sarvabhuta surita. Surit, friend, well-wisher, sarvabhuta. Why I shall think only well for my relatives or my family member? That is kripana, miser. A broad-minded brahmana should be engaged for doing good to all, everyone. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission is prithivite ache jato nagaradigram. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never instructed that you should limit your preaching within your society or within your country. He is asking, prithivite ache jato nagaradigram. As many villages and towns are there, on the surface, that's all, I don't need to stop. Sarvatra prachar haive man. This is the mission. This is Vedic knowledge. Sarvabhuta surhit. You should become why you are taking it? They come, can inside. We are dropping this. So we should be engaged sarvabhuta hite rata. Everyone should be taken as friend. Sridhang sarvabhutana. This is the qualification of an advanced Krishna conscious person. So this qualification, ayam hi suta sampanya sila vritya gunalaya jitaprata mridu danta. Danta means self-control. Shanta danta. Shanta means how to become self-controlled, not to become disturbed by the senses. These are training for a first-class human being. But there is no class. Nowadays it is said classless. First class and last class, all one. This is the modern philosophy. But that is not very scientific proposal. The scientific proposal is that there is first-class man and there is tenth-class man, but everyone can be utilized for the ultimate goal of life. That is classless. And that means everyone can become Krishna conscious. It doesn't matter whether by his qualification he is first class or last class. Krishna consciousness is transcendental. First class, last class is considered in the material world. But so long one is not on the platform of Krishna consciousness, for him this training is required to become a first class man. And for a Krishna conscious person, if he simply becomes Krishna conscious, then automatically he becomes a first class man. This is the secret of success. Kivalaya bhaktya vasudeva parayana dhunanti agham nihara miva bhaskar. It is said, dhunanti every sinful reaction becomes washed away. If one becomes vasudeva parayana, kivalaya bhakta, all these qualities can be attained by a devotee automatically. Jashasi bhakti bhagavati akinchana sarvai gunai tatra samasati sura. Sarvai gunai, all good qualities, as it is said, gunalaya, the reservoir of all good qualities. This can be attained, this stage can be attained only by training in Krishna consciousness. So, about Ajamil, the Jamadutas, they said, we know that this man, Ajamil, was fully qualified before. Vitabrata, Nitudanta, Sattvang, truthful, never speaks untruth. Satta, Sama, Dama, Satta. Or Sattvang means Param Sattam Dhimai. Param Sattam is Krishna, Vasudev, who is only speaking about Krishna, the Supreme Truth. He is called Sattvang. He does not speak anything. Kirtaniya Sada Hari. He is simply glorifying. If one's life is dedicated to preach about Krishna, then he is also Sattvam. He does not speak anything else. So our, these Krishna conscious members, they are simply trained to go and speak about Krishna. Therefore they are Sattvam. They do not speak anything else. They do not waste their time by speaking anything which has no relation with Krishna. That is Sattvam. Sattvam, mantravit. Mantravit means, vit means one who knows. And mantra means Vedic hymns, mantravit. So that word, Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna, this chanting is called Mahamantra. See, if anyone chants Hare Krishna, then he is not only mantravit, but is Mahamantravit. Because the Hare Krishna chanting is called Mahamantra. Mantravit. Mantravit Suchi. Suchi means Brahman. And Muchi means non-Brahman. There are two words still current in the Hindu society. Suchi and Muchi. Muchi means cobbler, dealing with skin. I am this skin. I am white skin, I am black skin, I am American skin, I am Indian skin. this understanding means Muchi. And Muchi is skin's expert. This is cow skin, this is goat skin, this is lamb skin. Then he is called Muchi, skin expert. Modern technology has given the title tannery expert. So this tannery expert, if you become tannery expert, then you are Muchi. So there is a Bengali proverb, Muchi hoye suchi hoy, jodi Krishna bhaje. Everyone of us, we are all tannery expert. And we are created so many isms on the basis of becoming a tannery expert. Therefore they are called Muchi. So Muchi hoye suchi hoy. And suchi means Brahman, pure. He has no such sense of becoming a tannery expert. He is Brahmana, Brahmavid. One who knows Brahma, he is called Brahmana, he is suchi. He is no more tannery expert. Therefore it is said, if from the Muchi platform, if you want to become suchi, really Brahmana, purified, then you have to take to Krishna consciousness. Muchi hoye suchi hoy, jodi Krishna bhaje. If one becomes Krishna conscious, then from the platform of becoming a Muchi, one becomes suchi. Therefore we have no caste distinction, because our process is to elevate the Muchi to the platform of suchi, this Krishna consciousness movement. Actually, that is the fact. We are unnecessarily becoming tannery expert. That is not the aim of life. The aim of life is to become suchi, to become Brahmana, or the person who is aware of Brahma. Brahma janati iti Brahmana. This is the philosophy. But nobody is interested to become a Brahmana. Everyone is interested to remain a Muchi and tannery expert. That is not the aim of life. So this is training. Muchi hoye suchi hoye. One can be trained up to become a suchi from the platform of Muchi. And even though one is born of a suchi family, if by practice he is not Krishna conscious, then he automatically becomes a Muchi. Suchi hoye Muchi hoye jodi Krishna taje. If one gives up Krishna consciousness, even though he is born in a Brahmin family, or even though he has practiced Brahminism, still, on account of his not accepting Krishna consciousness, he is accepted as Muchi. Suchi hoye Muchi hoye jodi Krishna taje. And Muchi hoye suchi hoye jodi Krishna bhaje. If one is Krishna conscious, then is suchi. This is. So, this Ajamil became suchi, Brahmana. Then Guru Agni, Guru, the spiritual master, Agni, the fire, and Atithi. Atithi means uninvited guest, hospitality. If somebody comes at your home without your invitation, he is called Atithi. Tithi means particular time and date. But a person arrives at your home without any invitation on particular time and date. He is called atithi. Atithi satkar, this is also one of the items of Vedi culture. Atithi satkar. So, the sannyasis especially, they are begging from door to door. So they have no fixed up program in which door he'll go on which day. No. Anywhere they approach. The word atithi means generally the brahmachari and the sannyas. Brahmachari is also begging alms from door to door, and a sannyasi also allowed, but door to door does not mean that he would collect more than is necessary. But he does not cook. A sannyasi goes to a pure householder's life, a home, because generally in a Brahmin's house or Kshatriya or Vaishya, but not to a Shudra. This is the distinction. Why? Because the three upper classes, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, especially the Brahmana, they are considered the topmost. They have got Vishnu worship at home. Still, in all Brahmin's family, ancestral Shalagram Shila is worshipped in a Brahman family. So also in Kshatriya family. So these sannyasis go to a Brahman family because it is known fact the Brahmanas are engaged in worshipping Vishnu. Brahmana means Vaishnava. Brahmana means Pandit. Therefore, two words are used along the word Brahmana. Brahmana Vaishnava, Brahmana Pandit. Suta Sampanna. The first qualification is Suta Sampanna. He must be learned, scholar in Vedic. Vedic knowledge means Shruti. So that is the first qualification. Ayam hi suta sampanna. So therefore Brahman is Pandit. Without becoming a Pandit, how he one can become Brahman?
No.
Suta sampanna. Suta sampanna, then Guru Agni, very respectful to spiritual master Agni, the fire, because a Brahmana has to make fire sacrifice every day, Guru, Agni. And Atithi, Atithi is a sannyasi, they are coming to a Brahmana's house for one chapati. They don't want more. They are called Madhukari. Madhukari means madhu. Madhu is collected by drop, not in lump. The what is called bees? Honey bees? No, honey and bees, what is called madhumakshi? Bee, bumble bee, yes. So they collect a drop. From this flower drop, that flower drop, that flower drop. In this way they make a big honeycomb. So Brahmanas and Kshatriya, again, sannyasis, although they're meant for collecting, they do not collect heavy at a place, little, because they are collecting not for his sense gratification. He is collecting for satisfying Krishna. So everyone is given chance. that you give little, you give little, you give little, and whole thing is engaged in Krishna's service. And just like here, we have got the container of flour and container of rice. So although we are feeding 200 men daily, still it can be collected by musti. Everyone, grihastha, can come and place one musti atta. That is not difficult for him. He has got children, family, he is consuming 5 kilos of atta daily. Out of that little, if it is put into the temple, he does not feel any burden. Therefore the collection, sannyasi, brahmachari collects little, little, little from everywhere. That is called madhukari. Exactly following the footstep of madhukar, bamboo bees. So, they are very, the householder, this is meant for the householder especially. This is the ideal household. Guru Agni Atithi Vridhyana. Old man also should be taken care of. Nowadays the philosophy is coming, mercy killing. Old man should be killed to show him mercy, because he is burden in the society, the communistic theory. Old man does not do anything and simply eats. Therefore, to show him mercy, he should be killed. Mercy killing. Just see the philosophy. Killing is mercy. But this is going on. Mercy killing. Is that mercy killing? What is that?
They kill someone for that person's benefit.
Benefit.
Not somebody for
the man, killer, will he take that benefit? If he, somebody comes that I shall kill you for your benefit, that will be afraid of. But he is philosophizing mercy killing. This is going on. So, one should be respectful also to the old man. According to the Vedic knowledge, Brahman, old man, child, woman, and cow, they have no fault. They are free. They are not within this jurisdiction of law. Therefore, cow killing, Brahman killing, woman killing, and elderly person killing, they are accepted as the great sinful activities. So, Gurbhagni Atithi Vridhyana Shushushu Ranahankrita. Anahankrita, not with any pride or puffness. Anahankrita, very humbly. Sarvabhuta Suritam. This is the most exalted qualification to become well-wisher of all living entities. Not that we open hospitals for the human being and we send the cows to the slaughterhouse, the poor animals to the slaughter. That is not Suita Sarvabhutana. That is partiality. And it has no meaning. If you become envious to other living entities, and if you become friend of a particular living entity, that is not good qualification. Suida Sarvabhutam. Sarvabhuta Suit. Sadhu. He is sadhu. Sadhava Sadhu Bhushana. These are the qualifications of a sadhu. Suida Sarvabhutam. Sadhava, Sadhu Bhushana. Everything is described in the Vedic literature. All, I mean, description. So this Ajami's past qualification is described in this, that he was well qualified Brahmana, well trained, because this qualification became manifested in his life. Then his degradation began. He goes asu banunga jata pitri sandesha ki dija adaya tatva avritya phalapushta samit kushan dadarsha kaminam kanchit chudram saha bhujishaya. That this we may describe later on. And how degradation begins, even to exalted person, as described, Ajami. So the degradation began, dadarsa, he saw on the way, kaminam kanchit chudram. Chudram, this male-female behavior. Nowadays, not so much in India, but in the Western countries, it is very usual thing. A young man is embracing another young woman or kissing. So there is no fault. But according to Vedic civilization, this is fault. Because it will give chance to others. Nowadays in pictures they are also shown. To enthuse others to become lusty. And that is the beginning of his fall down. But there is no restriction. The young man, they are seeing daily in the cinema, on the road, in their school, college. But this Ajami, although he was so exalted a Brahmin, simply by seeing one Shudra, Shudra means who has no training, fools, rascals. So he was embracing another woman, and that became attractive to this Ajami. And then he wanted to do the same thing, and he became degraded. This will be described later on.